Money Talks is brought to you by the Heritage Family Credit Union. Your community, your credit union. Champlain College is actively collecting research from participating high schools across Vermont when it comes to personal finance. The Center for Financial Literacy is offering a graduate intensive course on personal finance during the summer for teachers. The class was developed to help Vermont teachers bring the lessons they learn back to their schools and students.
So we've had predominantly high school teachers from across Vermont. I think it's more than 78% of the supervisory unions in the state have attended our Summer Institute, which is a 1 week, 45-hour, very intensive course taught with, I think, 25 to 28 instructors each year. So it's pretty fast-paced, and the goal of the program is to talk about financial literacy as it relates to their life, but also really focus on, you know, the curriculum tools that they can bring back into the classroom to make it work. It's an incredibly effective program. It's been recognized by the White House in a report in 2012. We've had a national study look at our data that was put out by the National Endowment for Financial Education. And probably the single statistic that I can give you about the teachers is their response to a question that has to do with their confidence levels and their ability to teach personal finance. Before they show up in the course, and by the way, most of these teachers are already teaching this in the classroom, so they've self-selected into taking the course. 39% of them felt confident or highly confident in their ability to teach personal finance in that high school classroom. When they left right after the class, that goes up to 94%.
Peltier is a proponent of requiring students to take personal finance as a graduation requirement. Most schools in the state don't offer the class, or if they do, it's an elective.
The educational requirements need to change in the state to make this important. And you know, we right now we're creating a system of changing to the Common Core mathematics. And if you go to what Common Core is all about, particularly with math, it's about teaching math using real life situations, understanding how math can be applied to your life or maybe to your workplace as an engineer or a scientist. I can't think of anything more real life than money. You know, it's the one thing that all of these young people will think about every day when they're on their own. There isn't a day that goes by that you don't think about money, because you need to think about it to buy something, whether it's food or, you know, a can of Coca-Cola. You know, where's that money coming from? And we don't really teach it.
Another measure Peltier would like to see schools do is associate how a chosen career path can impact the amount of money you make in the future.
So your career choice is tied to income. And the other thing is that your major, so if you're part of that group that plans on going to college, your major will impact your income. And what we know based on studies, when you ask, you know, recent college graduates, why did you choose the major you chose, it's always about passion. There's never an economic analysis as to what does somebody make when they've been doing this job for 5 or 10 years? What's the median income? And it's unfortunate that career choice and bachelor's degree choice or a college degree choice isn't being made at the high school level the way it needs to be, because right at that point in time when you graduate from high school, you're making one of the most important financial decisions potentially of your life, which is how much student debt to get into.